Hello, everybody, ¿cómo están? This is your friend, el Dr. José Luis Medina Hernández Franco López Jr. Díaz Cruz, and today is Monday, August the 26th, and I'm here with your hashtag Medina Monday message. I have some gossip, some chisme. Did you know that some of us as teachers, we actually write our learning targets for the adults in the building? No, de veras. De veras, we'll write like the students will be able to, and then we'll put like 2.4B to the end power and then state the TEEC, the Common Core Standard, or the SOL. No, de veras. And we fail to realize that students have to own their objectives, their learning targets, in order to fully create an equitable environment in the classroom. And so today I want to focus on language objectives porque son los más difíciles para nosotros, ¿verdad? They're the ones that kind of freak us out. Remember that if we write a content objective without a language objective, that's like asking kids to find a target in the dark. A content objective without a language objective is like finding a target in the dark. Así es que, contrólate, ¿verdad? Don't be freaked out. Language objectives don't have to be that difficult. Three steps. Step number one, go ahead and identify a verb that has to do with a 4+1. That's listening, speaking, reading, writing, and making cross-linguistic, metalinguistic connections, ¿verdad? Second step, link it to the TEEC, to the SOL, to the Common Core Standard. That's what you do. And then the third step, add an interaction. It could be with another student, with a partner, with a class, with a teacher, with a graphic organizer, with a text. Add some type of interaction. And so, for example, if the content objective, the content learning target is, I can identify geometric shapes, then the language objective would be, I can orally describe geometric shapes to a partner. That's it. Connect it to the 4+1, connect it to the standard, and add an interaction. I'm giving you some examples below, eh? Nos vemos.